Are you suffering from task burnout or maybe even work-life balance? Well, there's an app for that and it's called Sunsama, and it's a daily planner app that wants you to help you to better plan quality tasks, not quantity tasks. Today, we're going to give you insights into features and give you a full review on the application. We're going to touch on pricing and where it's available to download, as well as everything you need to know about this application. Hello there, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. If you're interested, you can check out toolfinder.co as well as get a link to Sunsama below. If we have a deal on Sunsama, you'll find it below because we're the best place to find productivity tools. And if you're hunting for more to-do list apps, you'll find a link below to explore all of the resources that we have. So Sunsama, a very interesting app because what it wants to do is focus on quality, not quantity. And it has a few other abilities that are going to help you to do that. Today, let's start with the pricing and then dive into features. So let's dive in. So let's start with the pricing, and Sunsama is not free. There is a 14-day free trial, and if we have any deals, you can find it linked below, which should give you access to more months, and I'll find the link up here in the top right-hand corner. But largely, this application is paid, which means it's either going to be $20 a month rolling or $16 per month billed annually. So a little bit more up front and a little bit shaved off the yearly pricing. Now, I wanted to talk firstly about the task management aspects and all of the features because we need to work out whether it's right for you and whether it's worth it for your money. Obviously, you might be looking at some of the other options, so do check out our reviews for those too. Now, task management inside of Sunsama is really easy to do. Each of the tasks you create allows you to add a description, a due date, and a duration. This is perfect for setting the planned time for the task and helps you to establish the value of each task, really. And then you can organize it in something called a channel. Now, there are two different types of things inside of this channels area. There's context and channels. Channels are built into context, which means you can add things like projects to a context like work, or you can add things like garden to your personal area. But the great news is those contexts can be organized and filtered, meaning you can switch between modes when work's finished to go over to personal and vice versa. There are also time zones so that you can see additional time zones on your calendar, which is a great customization. But adding tasks is really easy, and you can actually add each task to an objective, which is a great feature if you're somebody that wants to break into more zoomed out productivity, which we'll talk about a little bit later. Now, inside of the main area, you can actually organize this view, not just in board, but in calendar and calendar weekdays, week, month. There's a few different options, but not a customized way to see them. And this is a great way for seeing your tasks inside as well as your events, because I've connected up in the settings my Google Calendar. And if I go into integrations, you can add a Google Calendar, a Outlook, and an iCloud, which is really helpful. Now, going back to the task area before we jump into calendar, on this right-hand side, you can see a panel of your day ahead. That's because I've switched to that view, but if I go back to board view, I can see the opposite, calendar inside of my area here, which means I can drag any of the tasks and time block them into my calendar and my Google Calendar. You can see these up here, you can switch between them easily. Now, I'll talk about the task consolidation later because that's a great feature. But in terms of task management, there is a feature called Backlog, which will allow you to add your tasks that are maybe not important and you're not ready to commit to it yet, but it's a great way to break tasks down and capture them for later. Now, the mobile apps aren't particularly great. If you look at the mobile app, it's much more of a reader version experience. So that's just something to note. Now, let's jump over to calendar view. If I go to the calendar view for today, I can filter by calendar, and I can see that at the top in the corner, and I can see a few different calendar views like 3-day, weekday, and week view as well as month view, which is much more of a zoomed out experience than you've got. Now, as I mentioned earlier, there are integrations for adding Google Calendar, Outlook, and iCloud. iCloud is more recently added and will help you to connect up with the likes of any of your Apple devices, which is really helpful. Now, there are a bunch of abilities when it comes to using your calendar. For example, in this area, you can actually see all of the different settings around the calendar. You can add things like your Google, your Zoom integration, which is great for setting up meetings, and your Google Contacts integration. And if I click into the calendar, I can actually create an event straight away with that Google Meet and Zoom available instantaneously. So I can actually invite people to meetings and do everything from here, which is great. Now, if I go back to that board view, I can see the calendar view here, which means that any of my tasks that I have in my system, I can organize them in the day. So for example, if I wanted to drag this one in here and I wanted to make it slightly longer than I can do, which is great. And time blocking is a fantastic system for organizing what you want to do for the day. So obviously, everything is underpinned by this concept of task consolidation, because as you can see here, I've got Todoist connected up, which is a really interesting experience. So for example, if I've got my today area in Todoist, I can actually add tasks to my Sunsama from Todoist. And you can see that that little indication means that it's active and live in Todoist. Now you're probably wondering, why would I add things like my Gmail or maybe even other things like GitHub or Jira or Trello or Asana or Notion and many more? Why would I do that? Well, this is perfect for reducing something called context switching so that you can stay on task instead of jumping between apps, updating them. And if something's assigned to you, then it means that you can then drag it into your Sunsama and almost like own it a bit more, or organize it at least into an area that you want to do. So for example, if I needed to record, which I am now, I can drag that Todoist task in here, and that means it lives in my calendar. That's perfect for really organizing it and breaking it down to where it's important. Now, obviously, what underpins the experience is the fact that you've got these pins on the right-hand side, literally underpins. And that's much better than the access you get inside of AccuFlow, in our opinion, because that's something that's very accessible. Whereas in AccuFlow, it sort of filters into the inbox area, which can get a little bit overwhelming, but at the same time, it's a very helpful experience. So in terms of scheduling, there's a few things to note and how that works. And I want to talk about this with guided planning, because it's a great experience once you get it going. So for example, I've got a few tasks here and you can notify. So for example here, if I were to delete these because I made some poor demonstration of them, if I were to add another task to the list to do, just as a demonstration, and I put it as maybe, I don't know, 3 hours, you can see here that I got an indication for how long this is going to take me across the day. And I can also see up here, I've got 5 tasks remaining for the day. Now you're probably wondering, why is that useful? Well, when I go over my limit, then it's going to indicate, actually, okay, you need to stop or you're overloaded with tasks. And when I try and project something onto the calendar, for example, if I would be able to organize that into the today area and I try to overload it, for example, here, it says you're overcommitting to your experience. This is great because it's a little bit of auto-scheduling, not as much as you would see in AI apps like Motion, but it's definitely a good way to help you defer items for later. You can also adjust your schedules in the settings area, which is going to help you to reorganize that. Now, there's also a overdue area. So if I go to the archive, I believe it's called, here we go. Anything that is at least 4 days consecutively missed will go to archive, which is sort of like a nice experience for those who want to see their overdue. And you can see that you can switch this off up here if you did want to. Obviously, if I don't switch off, it completely overwhelms my system because I haven't touched it in a while. But as you can imagine, a great way to just try to keep that spring cleaned and organized. So the good thing here is if I add this to calendar, I can also schedule it or defer it. But if I scheduled it anyway and went to my calendar view, it'll obviously break past that. And there are some days that I might have to do that. But there's also, if I were to say, remove a task from the calendar, say I had a task of task one and I wanted to be able to organize this. It's going to take me 30 minutes long. And I want to be able to add it to the calendar. Obviously, that's going to be absolutely fine. But if I were to increase the planned time of it, for example, it might be a little bit longer, then it's going to give me this little preview view, which I can naturally shuffle things around. But as you can see, everything's adaptive too, which is a great way. And if it's longer and you've set it longer, then what it's going to do is it's going to find gaps for you, which is very helpful. So the concept of auto-scheduling is baked into this. There's also a feature for those tasks that you have that are recurring for repeat, where you can add it at roughly at this time, which means that if you have something on a recurring basis, like emails, or you have it for daily, or maybe even feed the cat, I don't know, maybe you do it weekly, I don't know, that's really poor. But if you were to have that, then these will allow you to, when you're setting up the auto schedule, to try and follow those same rules so that when you go forward, you're not pushing the boundary on them and not breaking things like lunchtime and things like that that you have on a routine basis. So if you're using this application, it's because you want a better system for planning your tasks. I want to talk about the guided planning in a moment, but let's talk about the timer and focus experience because this is great. Once you have a task, you can open this focus mode and start a timer. This little thing here lives separately, which means you can take it in and out of the application. You can write notes down here, add subtasks, and if you hover over this side, you can see your preview for the day. You can jump into a Pomodoro session, which means you can see all of the sessions you've had and increase it or decrease it by 5 minutes, and that's great for focusing on task. Now, obviously you want to in focus mode, there's this almost this focus view, which is gonna block out everything, but there's also something called daily task view, which is just gonna focus you on your today area, which is really nice. Now, the guided planning abilities are pretty decent, but let's show you the AI functions first. Now, remember I mentioned earlier I created a task called task, just for demonstration purposes. If I add that again, because I added it as a 30-minute task last time, it's remembered that and it's added to my personal. But for example, if I wanted to add feed cat, then it put that as a work task, but the AI is designed to try and understand your tasks and put them into the relevant channel and how long it's gonna take. Obviously, feed the cat isn't gonna take that long, but if I put write article, let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so it's gone with personal, but 45 minutes is roughly the time I need to complete an article, I think. So obviously it's gonna learn from you over time and become better. So what's really nice as well is you can use guided planning to help you be more efficient. Let me show you how that works. Inside of this area, say for example, I was midway through a day, I can click plan and I can actually add and fill events that are in my day, and I can see the predicted workload for the day. So for example, in this case, I have 3.5 hours available apparently, and this is my preferred shutdown time, which I can change if I want to, and I can click next, and I can see how that's organized for the day, as well as adding a daily shutdown to the day ahead. So for example, if I look at my plan, I can set a daily plan and I can get started with it. Now this is great if you're planning ahead because it will do it even more efficiently, but it's almost like a systematic process that you go through. You can also do the same for your week and a week review in total to see what you got done on the days. For example, that day, I got that task done, and you can go through the process of it and even write yourself a weekly review. So what's really nice about this experience is you can also do it for the shutdown. At the end of a day, it'll help you to go through all of that. And as you can see, it's done for the day, which leaves you with a really nice quote that you can go into, and it shuts down your Sunsama account, which is really nice. Now, if you want to be a bit more proactive and plan the day ahead, that's great because it can start to help you to visualize what you're working on. But in general, this is a great way to plan ahead and be a bit more effective. The best way to manage this is to go into settings and go to rituals and really set things up into more detail, even setting up things like automated daily planning, when you want to start your day and things like that. That's why it's much more of the work balance application, because it's got this element of, okay, you need to focus on quality tasks, not quantity tasks. So let's take you through a few of the different things. You can invite other people to your account. This allows you to set up channels that you can use in work and also organize schedules for your team. This will help you to bring in tasks for other people and collaborate on certain items. I'll show you what that looks like on screen. So how and who is this best for? Well, Sunsama is best for those who want to focus on quality tasks, not quantity. It's designed around a much more mindful productivity system. It will not have all of the power features like artificial intelligence. It will not have, I think, in my opinion, beautiful views. It has a minimal work-life focus that will help you to consolidate your tasks and bring in some good calendar. This obviously is the same or similar pricing to things like AkiFlow and Motion. And to be honest, in our opinion, is a really good application and has something slightly different to what other apps have in terms of the focus and the experience that you're getting with mindfulness. So if you're looking to zoom out, not zoom in, this is a great application for that. Now, I'm going to be really annoyed if I miss telling you this. I forgot to tell you about a feature. There's weekly objectives. Now, the weekly objectives are great because you can do things quite fast. For example, if I was like, record 5 videos, I can add it and then I can automatically create time across the week for those tasks. For example, if I was in a rush for the week and I wanted to zoom out, focus on certain things, I can quickly add a bunch of tasks and actually do them. So there are so many zoom out approaches to this app. and it's well worth considering if work-life balance and burnout is something you're struggling with right now. Find a link to it below, and if you're still hunting for to-do list apps, jump over to Toolfinder and we'll help you find them there.